Can you recall recent flooding disasters? They're ingrained in my memory. The Asian tsunami on December the 26th, 2004, that resulted in the deaths of over 300,000 people and left hundreds of thousands of people homeless. Think of Hurricane Katrina striking the Gulf Coast of America and flooding New Orleans in August 2005 with over 1,800 fatalities. Or Hurricane Ike that made landfall in the Galveston-Houston Bay Area in September 2008. The storm surge destroyed the homes of many people. Or what about the destructive force of Hurricane Sandy impacting on New York in October 2012? Can you also remember the distressing images of the Japanese tsunami in March 2011? Or perhaps the flooding and destruction from Typhoon Haiyan striking the Philippines in 2013? All of these disastrous floods happened fairly recently. Earlier floods, such as the 1953 flood that impacted England and the Netherlands, displacing over 100,000 people, made the Netherlands realize they had to act. They responded with a comprehensive plan to improve their flood defenses, constructing levees, dikes, and storm surge barriers over a period of 50 years. I expected a similar response to the recent flooding disasters. What do you think? I expected the different countries to design and construct hydraulic structures to improve their flood defenses. But let's examine what actually happened. How did these countries respond? Well, we see a number of newspaper headlines showing that natural or ecosystem-based alternatives are considered in addition to hydraulic structures. In the Philippines, for instance, a town was saved by their mangroves. This made such an impression that mangrove areas are being restored as part of the flood defenses in the Philippines, and in Vietnam, and in Indonesia. We see a similar trend in America, with natural infrastructure forming the focus of the many recovery efforts after Hurricane Sandy, and many people getting involved in restoring dunes. In Louisiana, the state in which New Orleans is located, they also opted for a combined strategy, building levees and restoring marsh areas to bring their flood defenses up to acceptable levels. What about the Dutch? They're moving from building hard hydraulic structures to including nature-based alternatives. Look at the sand engine. In South Holland, it uses natural dynamics to distribute a huge sand nourishment along the coast, preventing erosion and improving flood safety. Clearly, building with nature is a worldwide trend in hydraulic engineering. But what is it exactly, and how can you design building with nature solutions? Well, in the fourth week of the course, you'll be making your own building with nature design by applying engineering and ecological principles that you've learned. And if you're curious to see how other people's designs work out, stick with us in the peer review in the last week. I'm looking forward to a great course.